Thank you. All right. I think I'm good to go now. Welcome to worship. Nice to have you here on this very frosty morning. Thank you for joining us, those of you in the pews. And those of you joining us on the stream, we welcome you as well this morning. Before we get started with worship today, I have several announcements I want to share with you. First of all, our church email has been down since about Wednesday. Those of you may know that Buckeye Broadband, which supplies our email service here at the church, their email contractor was attacked by ransomware, and so their email has been down since Wednesday. They claim that nothing was compromised as far as data and information, so we'll take them at their word for now. But that means you can't communicate with the church by email right now. So be aware of that. That's why you didn't receive any announcements in the mail this week. However, the announcements are up on our website under the announcements tab. They also are on the back of your sermon notes this morning, so you can grab announcements on your way out if you didn't get them on the way in. All right, sorry for the inconvenience. Hopefully by next week it'll all be fixed. In 2 weeks, 2 weeks from today, on January 30th, we will be conducting our annual congregational meeting that'll take place at noon here in the sanctuary. This year, there's not a whole lot of business to take care of, but there's always the necessary business. We have to elect officers and council members. We have to pass a budget and so forth. So if you would put that on your calendar and try to be here, we would sure appreciate it. Also, we're still looking for a few people to serve as volunteer leaders of our congregation, serving on council. Those positions are listed in the announcements. So if you're interested in serving in one of these positions, please see me after the service or call me this week. We would be glad to have you. It's quite an honor and quite an educational experience to serve on church council. So be thinking about that. Be praying about that. Also, after church today, on your way out, you'll see there's a table set up, and the youth are going to be starting their annual Super Bowl sub-sale fundraiser. So stop and grab a sub-sale order form on your way out this morning. And finally, we will be communing at the Lord's table this morning. We will be doing it here in the front of the altar rail. We'll commune continuously by intinction. So just a reminder, hang on to your wafer when I give it to you and go to the cup station and dip your wafer in the cup. You have two choices. The purple liquid is wine. The golden liquid is grape juice. Okay? All right, if you're a guest or a visitor among us, if it's your custom to commune in your home congregation, by all means, please join us at the Lord's table this morning. Okay, I think that takes care of the announcements. Anything I missed? Okay, very good. We will begin our worship this morning with the brief order of confession and forgiveness. It's written on page 56 in the green book, and also the pertinent text will be on the screen as well. Would you please stand if you are able? We begin this morning in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy Scripture teaches us that if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let's take a few moments to reflect upon our own sinfulness, our need to confess, and our need to hear God's words of mercy again. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Jesus Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sin in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is a hymn that's not in our green book. The words will be on the screen. The hymn is Standing on the Promises. Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing, standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises that cannot fail, when the howling storms of doubt and fear assail. By the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of Christ the Lord, bound to him eternally by love's strong cord, overcoming daily with the Spirit's sword. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I cannot fall, listening every moment to the Spirit's call, resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Eternal Lord, your kingdom has broken into our troubled world through the life, death, and resurrection of your Son. Help us to hear your word and obey it, so that we become instruments of your redeeming love. This we pray through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. We continue our worship with the reading of the lessons.
The first lesson for today is found in the book of Psalms, the 69th chapter, beginning with the 6th verse. Lord, the Lord Almighty, may those who hope in you not be disgraced because of me. God of Israel, may those who seek you not be put to shame because of me. For I endure scorn for your sake, and shame covers my face. I am a foreigner to my own family, a stranger to my own mother's children. For zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who insult you fall on me. When I weep and fast, I must endure scorn. When I put on sackcloth, people make sport of me. Those who sit at the gate mock me, and I am the song of the drunkards. But I pray to you, Lord, in the time of your favor, in your great love, O God, answer me with your sure salvation. Here ends the lesson.
Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia, alleluia. The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 2nd chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Our lesson here begins at the 13th verse. When it was almost time for the Jewish Passover, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple courts, he found people selling cattle, sheep and doves, and others sitting at tables exchanging money. So he made a whip out of cords and drove all from the temple courts, both sheep and cattle. He scattered the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. To those who sold doves, he said, "Get these out of here. Stop turning my father's house into a market." His disciples remembered that it is written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. This morning, I want to review our memory verse from last week. If you'll remember, the memory verse was from Luke chapter 3:22. This was from the story of the baptism of Jesus. And you'll remember my sermon theme last week was that just as Jesus was called the beloved Son of God in his baptism, we also are beloved children of God. God called us beloved at our baptisms. So let's review this, and then we will speak it from memory. Speak it with me. You are my beloved Son. With you, I am well pleased. Let's do that one more time. You are my beloved Son. With you, I am well pleased. All right, now from memory. You are my beloved Son. With you, I am well pleased. Okay, very good. I picked another memory verse for you this morning. This one's a little harder, so we'll review it. This is from our lesson from Psalm 69 this morning, verse 9. Speak it with me. Zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who insult you fall on me. Certainly, these are words that many of us can relate to these days, especially that second part of this verse. I picked this verse because it relates to our gospel lesson this morning as well. Let's say this again. Zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who insult you fall on me. All right. Use this verse throughout the week. Commit it to memory if you would. It's an important verse to know in your faith life. My message title this morning is No More Business as Usual. No More Business as Usual. We see today in our gospel lesson something that I think is quite shocking if we stop and think about it for a moment. This is perhaps the only place in the Gospels of Jesus Christ where you see him actually act out of anger. He lifts his hand in the story today, according to our story, against the temple merchants. Jesus arrives at the temple and he finds there all kinds of merchants who are selling all kinds of animals for the sacrificial rituals that take place there at the temple. Also, there are money changers. People would bring all kinds of money to the temple, Roman money, money from other regions of the Roman Empire. And that money couldn't be spent in the temple. It had to be exchanged for a fee, of course, into Jewish money. And so when Jesus arrives there, he realizes that the temple has become not a place of worship, but a place of business. And this picks his righteous anger. His righteous anger wells to the top, so much so that he makes a cord and he goes around and he's whipping the animals out of the temple. And then he actually goes and overturns the tables of the money changers and the merchants. So I think here what we see is, you know, the veil is being pulled back on Jesus' humanity. We see here one of the same emotions that many of us, I think, from time to time experience. It's interesting to me, if you read the Gospels closely, you see Jesus experiencing all kinds of human emotions, compassion, sadness, regret, joy, mirth. Very seldom do you see him express anger. There are several places in the Gospels where he expresses annoyance, especially with his disciples who just can't seem to catch his drift in his teaching. But this is, as far as I know, the only place where we see Jesus expressing anger. So what's with that? Well, we'll talk about that here a little bit in a moment. One other thing I want to point out here is that the synoptic gospel writers, Matthew, Mark, Luke, they put this story way at the end of Jesus' life. They have this story in the last week of his life when he arrives in Jerusalem for the last time, that last week before he's crucified. And I suspect that chronologically, that's really where it took place. But you'll notice in John's gospel that it takes place almost immediately as Jesus comes on the scene. And I want to ask the question, why is that? Why did John put it right there in the beginning? Well, I think it's important for you to understand that John is not writing a chronological gospel. He is writing a theological gospel. He is laying out important themes in Jesus' life. And so you'll often notice that John's chronology doesn't match up with Matthew, Mark, and Luke very often. Sometimes it does, but not often. So it's important, I think, for us to understand that John is putting this story right at the beginning of his gospel narrative, because it tells us something important about who Jesus is and what he's about. Well, what might that be? Well, the first thing I want to point out to you here is that with this act, Jesus takes his place in a long line of Jewish prophets. One of the missions that he fulfills, one of his callings, is to be a prophet, to call Israel back to faith in their God, Yahweh. And so one of the ways he does this is through performing prophetic acts. And this I think, is one of the most dramatic. What Jesus is really doing here at the temple is he is performing a prophetic act. He is calling the leaders of the temple. He's calling the priests. He's calling the religious leaders of Israel back to a more faithful expression of their religion, of their faith in God. He's saying to them, you've allowed things to get out of control here. You have turned our Father's house of worship into a place of business. And really not just plain ordinary business, okay? The priest and the leaders have allowed the merchants to charge interest rates that are exorbitant. Oftentimes the priest would reject animals that weren't absolutely perfect. You know, like a poor farmer would bring in an animal to sacrifice at the temple, maybe bring it 20, 30, 50 miles. They would bring it into the temple, and the priest would reject it. Oh, it's not perfect. And then that person to sacrifice would have to go to one of these animal merchants. And, of course, this animal merchant charged a premium for the animals that he was selling, and the priest let them get away with it. That's why in the Synoptic Gospels, Jesus quotes the prophets in saying, you have turned my house into a den of robbers. So Jesus is standing in that long tradition of Isaiah and Jeremiah and Ezekiel and Micah and Amos. In fact, to me, Jesus reminds me most of Jeremiah. In Jeremiah 27, God tells Jeremiah that the Babylonians are going to be attacking and defeating Israel, the nation of Judah, because of Judah's unfaithfulness to God. And he says, to make this point, I want you to make an oxen yoke, and with straps and a pole, and put it over your shoulders, and I want you to walk through the city and proclaim to the people to get ready, because Babylon is coming as a rod to exercise God's judgment on Judah. As you can imagine, that upset the religious leaders and the king, the royal leaders, quite a lot. In fact, they threw Jeremiah in jail because of it. And so in that same vein, Jesus is doing the same thing. You can bet that the religious leaders of Jesus' day were not happy with his message that he was proclaiming. But, you know, Jesus served God, not men. All right, so Jesus comes here and proclaims this prophetic message. And what is the message? The message is change is coming. God is not satisfied with the complacency of the current Jewish practice of the faith. And so it's no longer acceptable for you to go about your business as you've been doing it. It's no longer acceptable for you to allow, the temple to be defamed in this way. It's no longer acceptable for you to go about your business without regards to the poor, without regards to the people on the margins. And so he says, it's no longer business as usual, no longer playing temple, no longer playing church. The time has come to worship God in spirit and truth. Indeed, in a couple chapters, Jesus will say that to the Samaritan woman at the well. He will say, God is looking for people who are willing to worship in spirit and in truth. Not just go through the motions, but sincerely and genuinely worship God Almighty. So change is coming, Jesus says. It's not going to be pretty, I think he's saying. As I mentioned earlier, this is the only place in the Gospels where we truly see anger well up in Jesus. Jesus' beef with the Jewish people, and especially their leaders, was that they were only paying lip service to God. They knew the Word of God. They knew what the Word of God said about worshiping in the temple. They knew about the rituals of sacrifice that helped them work out repentance and forgiveness in their life. And yet, it had become a rote exercise for them. Jewish practice had become obsessed with keeping traditions. Traditions were the most important thing. Washing pots before you ate. Washing your plates and your silverware before you ate. Ritually washing your hands, and so forth and so on. Those had become the most important things. The things that were closest to the heart of God that you saw in Holy Scripture had been left by the wayside. Things like loving your neighbor as yourself. Things like loving God with your whole heart, soul, and mind. Those had a deep Old Testament tradition. Love your God with your heart, soul, and mind was found in Deuteronomy chapter 6. And then Jesus repeated it himself in his own ministry, Matthew 22. Love your neighbor as yourself. Again, found in the Old Testament, Leviticus 19. Again, Jesus repeated that, Matthew 22:33. You see, Jesus, like Jeremiah, calls the people to embrace the ancient covenant that God made with the people. And it was a covenant of love. The Sinai covenant that God made with the people after they came out of Egypt and went to Mount Sinai, where God gave the Ten Commandments. That covenant was really about love. You know, God gave the Ten Commandments to Israel and indirectly to us because he loved them and he loves us. He wants what's best for us. He wants to provide some guide rails for how we live our lives. Think about those first three commandments that God gave Moses on Mount Sinai. You shall have no other gods before you, right? Honor the Sabbath and keep it holy. No idols. Don't worship any idols. Those three commandments, what are they about? They're about loving God with your whole life. And then the other commandments that come after it. Honor your parents. Don't steal. Don't murder. Don't commit adultery. Don't covet. Don't lie. What are those all about? Those are about how we love one another, aren't they? Love your neighbor as yourself. Don't do these things. Do the opposite of these things, God is saying. So the purpose of the prophet is to call people back to that central heart of God. And God's heart is a heart of love. So Jeremiah says to the people, Jesus says to the people, we should be saying to each other and to the people outside these walls, don't go through the motions. of life. Don't go through the motions of worshiping to excuse or cover up bad behavior. Let your worship work on you. Let it be a force in your life that helps you reform your life, that lifts you out of sinful behavior and allows you then to walk that path of righteousness that God has laid out for you. This today, what Jesus does is really a call to a life of genuineness, a life of integrity, a life of honesty, a life of humility lived out in the service of God. Let me share with you some words from the prophet Jeremiah that speak to this. These come from Jeremiah chapter 7. Here's what Jeremiah says to the people of God. This is what the Lord God Almighty, the God of Israel, says. Reform your ways and actions, and I will let you live in this place. Do not trust in deceptive words and say, this is the temple of the Lord, this is the temple of the Lord, this is the temple of the Lord. If you really change your ways and your actions and deal with each other justly, if you do not oppress the foreigner, the fatherless, or the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place, and if you do not follow other gods to your own harm, then I will let you live in this place, in the land I gave your ancestors forever and ever. But look, you are trusting in deceptive words that are worthless. Will you steal and murder, commit adultery and perjury, burn incense to Baal and follow other gods you have not known, and then come and stand before me in this house, which bears my name, and says, we are safe. Safe to do all these detestable things? Has this house, which bears my name, become a den of robbers? Folks, what we do here is serious business. Don't take it for granted. Don't go through the motions. When you come to this place, come with humble, repentant hearts that God may work in your life and change you for the better when you leave this place. That's my prayer for you. That's my prayer for me. Come, Lord Jesus. Amen. Will you join me in confessing our faith using the Apostles' Creed? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. As we prepare to go to the Lord in prayer, I have a joy I want to share with you here this morning, and I want to read it to you. This is from Jeremy Miller. Many of you know Jeremy is the vice president of our church council. He's also the acting president of our church council, and he and his wife, Abby, have been awaiting the birth of a daughter, and as you know, she has had some significant challenges, genetic challenges, and so here's what Jeremy wrote me. Violet Ann Miller arrived yesterday at 2:05 p.m. Uh, no, I'm, yeah, I think that's right, 2:05 p.m. She weighed 3 pounds, 14.8 ounces, and is 16.9 inches long. She currently needs breathing support. Thanks for your continued prayers. I am with her in the NICU. That's the neo intensive care unit, neonatal intensive care unit. She needs help to breathe, but is progressing. And so little Violet was about 4 weeks premature, and I think it's pretty normal for premature babies to require some assistance breathing. The most important thing is that her heart started. The doctors were most worried about little Violet's heart not wanting to start when she was born. So we give thanks to God for this birth. We'll continue to pray for Jeremy and Abby and Violet. We'll hope for the best, pray for the best for them today in our prayers. Are there other joys you'd like to share with the congregation this morning? Yes. Rick, welcome back. We're glad you've recovered. Thank God for healing. Other prayers. Yes. Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Thanks for sharing that, Ron. We'll continue to lift up and pray for those hostages that were released and for that Jewish community down in Texas here this morning. And also, Ron's point, I think, is well taken, that we always need to be diligent and vigilant in our own security here at St. Michael. Ron is in the process of reinstituting some of our security measures, so he'll have more to say about that in coming months. All right, other joys this morning. Yes? Sandy Fisher, is it your birthday today? This coming Saturday. All right, happy birthday. Yes, Sharon. Okay. So Sharon and Don Saloff's daughter, Julie, had bypass surgery and is doing well and coming home tomorrow. Okay. Anyone else have a joy this morning? Yes. Okay. Okay. All right. Thanks for bringing in the snacks today, Linda. And Carl, do you have something you'd like to say? Okay. All right. I thought someone else raised, yeah, Shirley?
Yes. I have a new grandson. My granddaughter, Cassie, and her husband, Josh, had a baby last night, a little boy. He was 6 months when he was born.
Awesome. Do you have a name?
Garrett.
Okay. So Shirley Hersberg's granddaughter, so this would be your great-grandson. Her granddaughter had a son, so that's Shirley's great-grandson, and his name is Garrett. So tell them we said congratulations. That's awesome. All right. Anyone else have a joy? All right. We want to add a couple people here to our prayer list. We want to add Ben Rohr to our prayer list. This is... I'm going to try to get this right here, Gene. Gene, your son-in-law is Andrew, and he's in the military, and his picture is one of them that hangs out in the gathering room. He is a member here, by the way. Served. He's a career military man, correct? And Ben is his brother. Is that right? Okay. And Ben has inoperable brain cancer. Is that correct? And has entered into hospice. So we want to pray for Ben, for God's presence and in his life and in the life of his family. Also, we want to pray for the family and friends of Jim Reichert. He's 50 years old. He's on a ventilator. Most likely won't make it through the day. I'm assuming that he has COVID. So we'll pray for Jim Reichert. Also, we want to pray for Randy Krueger. He is an employee of Karen at the Lambertville Hardware Store and is in the hospital. He has a sinus infection, and it says that they have induced a coma. I'm assuming to help him not be so uncomfortable and to help with the healing. So we'll pray for Randy as well. So anyone else we should pray for this morning? Yes. Sean O'Mara. Pray for the family and friends. Okay, family and friends of Sean O'Mara. All right, thank you. Yes. Yes, that's true. Thanks for bringing that up. We'll pray for Dan Holscheider. He's having surgery on Wednesday. Okay, so keep Dan in your prayers. All right. Anyone else? All right, let's bow our heads and pray. Heavenly Father, gracious Lord, we come here to your house, and we hope and pray that we come for all the right reasons, that we come because we honor you, Lord God. We come because we love you. We come, Lord, to worship and to praise you. We come to pray to you. You've called us to prayer, and you've asked us to share with you our joys and our concerns. So we do both today. We're so thankful for a little Violet making it into this world alive. And we hope and pray, Father, that in accordance with your will, she will live and breathe and be loved by her family and by this church family for how many ever days, weeks, months, or years that you ordain. We're so grateful that Jeremy and Abby have her now in their life and are able to enjoy her this day. So watch over her and protect her. May she know your love and the love that you've poured out into our hearts. We pray for are thankful that several people have recovered from COVID and recovered from other illnesses in our congregation, especially Rick Williams, who joins us here today. We're so thankful he's back with us. But we also lift up prayer concerns today, Lord. We pray for Julie and healing. We pray for Randy. We pray for his healing. We pray for Ben, Lord, that you would surround him with your love during these last days of his life. We pray for Dan, that you would give him a successful surgery this week. We pray for comfort for the family and friends of Sean O'Mara. We pray the same for the family and friends of Jim Reichert. We ask and pray, Heavenly Father, that you bring healing to the Jewish synagogue down in Texas. We're so thankful that the hostages were rescued without injury. It could have ended so badly, but we're thankful for the first responders and the negotiators and all of the officials who worked to bring about a peaceful end to that horrible situation. So we thank you and we praise you, Lord God. Lord, hear our prayers, hear the prayers that we lift in our hearts. Here are our prayers for those on our prayer lists. Lord, bring your healing power into our lives and do for us as is best for us in accordance with your will. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord, we ask and pray that you help us to stay focused on what it means to be a child of God, saved by the grace of Jesus who died for us on the cross. We pray, Father, that when we come to worship you, when we come together to fellowship, when we come together to study your word, that we will keep you, Heavenly Father, and your Son, Jesus Christ, at the center of our activities. Lord, we come to serve you. We come to this place only to serve you. We do not come here to do business. We do not come here for to do all sorts of other things, Lord. We come here to worship and serve you. Lord, make this a central focus of our congregation, not just today, but every day, every Sunday that we gather here, every day that we gather here. Lord, may it be for the right reasons. Lord, as we worship you, as we praise you, we come to repent, to turn from our sin, and turn to you that we might live for you alone. This is our hope and prayer. We pray, Lord, you will help us make this a reality in our lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your grace and mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us now share with God our tithes and our offerings.
Be fruitful, Lord, and fill to the brim our cup of blessing. Gather a harvest from the seeds that were sown, that we may be fed with the bread of life. Gather the hopes and the dreams of all, unite them with the prayers we offer now. Grace our table with your prayer and give us a foretaste of the feast to come.
Let us pray. Merciful Father, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Sharing our life, he lived among us to reveal your glory and love, that our darkness should give way to his own brilliant light. And so, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth. In mercy for our fallen world, you gave your only Son, that all those who believe in him should not perish, but have eternal life. We give thanks to you for the salvation you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts, that we may receive our Lord with a living faith as he comes to us in this Holy Supper. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Then our Lord took the cup. He gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, blood shed for you and all people for the forgiveness of your sin. As often as you drink it, do so in remembrance of me." We pray the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. We'll be communing this side of the church first. Hit the mute button. There you go. Okay. Yeah, we're going down front. Okay. The body of Christ given for you.
Our first communion hymn this morning is "Tis So Sweet to Trust in Jesus."
The body of Christ given for you. Okay, they have got it. Okay. The body of Christ given for you. Given for you. The body of Christ 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 given for you.
body of Christ given for you. The 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 body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you.
And joy and peace.
The body of Christ given for you. 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 Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you.
He is with me.
The body of Christ given for you.
With me to the end. Jesus.
The body of Christ given for you. I'm going to go get some more wafers.
Our second communion hymn
the
is
body of Christ
Blessed
given
Assurance.
For you. The body of Christ given 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 for you.
This is my song.
The body of Christ given for you. Is there anybody back here? The body of Christ given for you.
This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission. Visions of rapture, angels descending, bring from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
The body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. the blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you.
Thank you.
Would you please stand? Let us pray. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of those whom you have fed with one heavenly food, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and always. Amen. All right. We will be on our way with our next song, which is What a Fellowship. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
that's right, but they went in Friday, so it was a whole day. On Friday night. Okay. Yeah, because this condition is not, it's not a good, a good situation.
It's, I think, the quantities externally and internally.
Yeah.
I don't know all the details of this, but it's a genetic deal.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so far, so good.
Yeah.
All right, we'll
that's
talk
good.
To you later.
Okay. just before communion, I think, or?
Shorten it to 5 or something like that.
Right. But she doesn't make too much sense, but you know, she still feels drowsy in such a time. As far as I know, she hasn't lost her taste yet.
Well, hopefully she don't. I didn't.
Yeah. My mom still has no taste from when she got it. My dad has altered taste.
Oh, no. That's
so
weird.
They all got different symptoms. And I didn't get it at all.
Oh, that's good.
We had Kevin in from Prodigy. All of this, everything should work.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, because you know, we had some of these mics that was stuff that wasn't channeled into our what's called
right.
Everything. I went and tested everyone. You may have to get what you want, but
right.
It should all work. I'm in this one.
There was even a couple things. It was cute to see it so we could feel human.
Oh,
things.
Because Kevin ain't nothing he can't do with these. He knows that's what he does.
Right.
It sets up.
He should be here in a minute.
Let's just...
Oh, do you?
Yeah, we got like these wireless
those are cool
for our guitars so that we can go all over the stage wherever the heck we want. Then I just use these to hook up to our rack.
That's a nice way to do it.
Yeah.
I did that one band I was in. That was pretty cool. Mm-hmm. I don't think mine's legal anymore because of the frequency.
Oh, I don't know if ours are technically legal either, but we haven't had the time or the
well, if you bought it in the last, when the last change was, it's probably legal.
Okay. How often do they change it?
Whenever the FCC feels the frequencies are crowded or whatever.
But
I don't think they've done it for a while. I think they're probably.
Oh, okay.
All right, buddy. Good to see you. He's getting ready.
Right.
That I think I just use it for offering, so a little couple courses of it. Lord be glorified. It should be back in there. There should be an order, but it's going to be back most of the way, I think.
What's it called?
I hope.
What's it called?
Oh, it's Lord be glorified. And the bass is kind of really important. You know, we sort of do impromptu for the offering,
right.
So we just sort of do it a few times through. But since there's a lot of moving chords in there, so.
Yeah.
thought since we're only doing it a couple of times, it'd be nice and
right.
I got it right. Okay, then, Thousand Tongues is our first song. It's got some cool spots in here for both of you guys. For Allison, too, but she wasn't here. It's a kicking song. Pretty cool. Can I let play a little bit of it while you're tuning up? Let him mess with it a little bit. Challenge Kevin on this when he's right. Yeah, because I got you now, but I had to change a lot of stuff.
Sean, would you bring up Mike, too?
Yeah. I don't know where it's at. But.
We must have been away.
Yeah, must have been away.
So what all I need, John, is the...
leadership. And I'm going to have this side, you're going to have that side. It'll be fun.
Okay, I can try it.
It's an easy song. It'll be fun. So.
Got it.
All right. Can we move on? Because we're starting to run out of time.
Yeah. Here's a scary thing. It's not getting anything in my right.
And sometimes some of those chords are going bad. Kind of move this one. Kind of turn it.
Oh, yeah. Yep. That was it.
They're going bad. Yeah.
It's like I panned something all the way right, and I wasn't getting anything in it. I was worried that it was my in-ears going bad.
String. I will seek you.
all of my days. And I will follow all of your ways. And I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy of my praise. And I will bow down and hail you as King. And I will serve you and give you everything. I will lift up throne, and I will trust you all of my. Oh yeah, you alone. Okay, yeah. I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy of. I will bow down and hail you as King. And I will serve you, give you everything. I will lift up my eyes to your throne. And I will trust you. I will trust you alone. I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy of my praise. I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my. I long to worship. You alone are worthy of my praise.
And then, really,
yeah, I'm trying to get all my
family. And really, if we get a certain break, they know it.
Yeah.
I was thinking about it. You want to? That'd be fun.
Yeah.
This way,
yeah.
Because it's nice, because it, in the congregation, it's getting a good kick out.
Right.
You could still sing off some of the
stuff. Right. Yeah, I like it completely. I was singing for 6 hours straight.
Oh, okay. I hear it a little bit now. Yeah, he's got a partly blown out voice, too.
King.
And I will serve you.
I will serve
give you everything.
Everything.
I will lift up
my eyes to your throne.
I will trust you
alone.
We do the second chorus again, but then it's all the same. Good, good. Appreciate you doing that.
She did go up, yeah.
My eyes to your throne. Okay.
It did, yeah.
Right.
Hopefully they'll drown us out and it'll be all good.
All right, good.
Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turned his face away. His wounds which mark the chosen one bring many sons to glory.
You want to do a verse?
Thank you.
Okay, this one's
set you?
For me. You got this extension too that'll help. I think with the extension you'll have enough. I hope.
Let's just get me set up.
Okay.
Should I hear everything?
It's been a while since you sung with us. Yeah. This is fun.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
Who
so tell
it was
me what
set
I
for?
Here.
Let's turn it on to see if you can hear. Hearing that all right?
Yep.
Check, 1, 2, check, 1, 2. Now it's working. Got to spend a couple minutes on the other songs, but get close.
Okay.
How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. There's Christ should come in there, maybe with me too. How great the pain of searing. Well, if you want to, because it's kind of a chorus. Father turns his face away, wounds which mar the chosen. That weird timing. Many sons to hold. Watch, because the way that count is. It's a weird feel, though, I'm telling you. I struggle. Behold the man. Because you're weapons of mine. Oh.
paying my ransom. Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot give an answer. But this though with all my heart is worth a great ransom.
Seem good? Yeah, and then if you don't hit it, just kind of wait. You know, you'll feel it. The last verse is helpful because you got the backup singers.
Yeah, that helps a lot.
Let's do just a little bit of the Somewhere in the Silent Night and then go on because we don't have much time. But.
Is calm and all is bright everywhere, but in your heart tonight they're singing carols of joy and peace, but you feel too far gone and too far out of reach. Song, your broken heart has cried, hope is here, just lift your head, for love has come to find you somewhere in your silent.
Okay. Let's do a little bit of House of the Lord. We're going out with kind of another kicking one, so glad you guys like that first one. That one rocks, isn't it?
We worship the God who was, we worship the God who is, we worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors, he parted the raging sea. My God, he holds the victory. There's joy in the house of the Lord, there's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet, we shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord, our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet, oh, we shout out your praise.
Okay. That was a dry run. But it felt like church started, didn't it?